Okay, everyone, this is part two for week four's instructions. The next thing I wanted to kind of address is, again, some of the things I was seeing in the responses, the discussion posts, which overall I think have been really great to read. Y'all are doing really great work. A couple of things I want to address. So, in the previous video, I mentioned you want to make sure that you're answering every element of the prompt. That's part of the grade, right? So make sure that you, if need be, revisit that rubric for the discussion posts. Go back and look at some of the things that you've posted. Note that the grading will get harder. So in the first couple of weeks, I'm just looking to see that you're doing the work, you're putting effort in. The grading will get more intensive as we continue on. Okay, so for this week, the expectations are higher than last week. So just make sure that you're addressing all aspects of the prompt. I do want to pull up Microsoft Word. This is a blank document. Note that I work with the Mac, so it looks a little bit different than what you might be seeing, especially if you're using the online version of Microsoft Word through your Outlook email or however it is that you're accessing that, Gmail, Google Docs, that kind of thing. But I want you to make sure that you have the spelling and grammar check enabled. As I've mentioned, so I'm gonna put my face right in front of you. You need to be composing and drafting your posts in Microsoft Word. I really encourage you to do this. Of course, it is not a requirement because I'm not sitting beside you as you're working on your weekly posts, but it's something that is going to save you time because if D2L for some reason times out, which has happened, if your power goes out, if your internet connection is lost, you're going to lose that work. Okay, you don't want to lose that work. You want to make sure that you have a copy of it somewhere. But it's also beneficial because you need to be using the spell and grammar check features. I'm seeing a lot of just straight up spelling issues or lack of capitalization. It's a writing class, folks, so you have to make sure that you're taking the time to go in there, revise, edit, update, and post the best possible response that is written in the best possible way for you, right? Using Microsoft Word is going to help with that. So if you take a look, I'm just going to start typing. And I want you to notice that as I type, it's going to either correct capitalization at the start of a sentence, or it's going to highlight that I'm spelling something incorrectly. So okay. So I want you to notice, and yours is going to look a little bit different. It automatically capitalized the I here. I didn't type it that way. It just automatically did that because it's at the beginning of a sentence. So again, you want to make sure that you're just kind of picking up on these things. It is red underlining with a squiggly underline, a misspelling. So if I right click on that, it's going to correct it. And I want you to notice there's a little underline happening here, and that is because it needs to be AN because it's coming before example, which starts with a vowel sound. So why not use this to your advantage? Okay. So make sure that you are typing and drafting in Microsoft Word and using the features that are there to be a resource and to help you. There's really no reason to avoid that, especially because when it comes to academic work, writing papers, more often than not, you're going to need to submit in Microsoft Word format. So it's good to start kind of working through how to use it and what how to use it to your own benefit, right? So that's something that I want you to keep in mind, especially because your grade depends on it, right? So you want to do that kind of work and it will save you time in the long run. Another thing I want to kind of show you is how to respond to one another in the discussion areas. For the most part, I'm seeing this done correctly. And even if you do it incorrectly, it's not going to affect your grade, but it's just easier for me to grade your work, but also for people to kind of read the responses that you intend to one another. So I'm going to pull up my response in one of the weeks as an example. This is from the first week, right? So at the bottom, you'll see that I have a test response, right? And so what I think is happening is that some folks are going in and they see, somebody responding to their ideas, and then they'll hit reply to thread, right? Either here or here. Because it's D2L, I don't know why They have to have reply to thread here and here because that is just a little much and confusing. So I want you to make sure that you're hitting this reply. So if you hit that, it means you were replying to what I have responded here, not to the overall thread up here. Okay, and some of the language can be a little confusing. You're replying to what is my thread. This is me. This is my thread. Okay, so if you want to just generally reply, you hit this. Or if you see somebody's maybe response to your ideas, or if you want to respond to somebody else's, you want to hit the reply right here. I know it's a lot. D2L can be a lot. It's not as simple and straightforward as I think it should be, but it's what we have to work with. So just something to keep in mind. Another thing I want you to be aware of, is office hours. So I had to change the area where office hours are held, video conferencing office hours. So if you go to collaboration, remember you can scroll down to WebEx. And for Thursday's office hours, those are video, right? So I can meet you virtually so that we can have a face-to-face conversation. But where they are located right now is a little different than where I had anticipated them at the start of the semester. So instead of looking at the event calendar right here, you're going to click appointment booking. And on Thursdays, I will have a time from 12 to 1 p.m. blocked off for everybody. So if you need to set up an appointment, you'll see different blocks of time here. Mine looks a little different than yours because I don't have an actual complete student view. But you'll be able to block a 10-minute segment of time to have a virtual conversation with me. This is going to be really important when it comes to our consultations. You and I will meet face to face to discuss your paper portfolio down the road. So you need to get kind of comfortable with this. But it doesn't mean you have to book an appointment with me now. It just means I need you to know where to go, what to click, etc. So take a few moments to look at that in your area of D2L for our course. And note that this is for Thursdays. Remember that generally I'm in the instant message area for office hours. So if you click on the envelope icon and click on instant messages, there will be a pop-up window and you'll see information there about how to meet virtually for those instant messages. And that's just like chat, right? And as a last kind of opportunity, if we need to meet for a phone conversation, my phone number is included on our syllabus, but we need to set up an appointment for that because I don't have my ringer on during the day. So if you call, I won't answer it, and it's likely I will not answer it if it's a number I don't recognize because we haven't set up an opportunity to discuss things. Okay, so that's what's going on for this week. If you do have any questions or concerns, you can always post in the Q&A area of D2L those discussion boards, or you can shoot me an email. But again, please make sure the information is not covered either on the syllabus or in the weekly video. But always look at the Q&A area because somebody else may have posted that question. I may have posted a question I received via email and respond to it. That's a really good way to kind of make sure everybody's getting information. But of course, email is always an opportunity and those office hours as well. I do want you to note that I might have to be going out of town this week, and so my access to internet and being able to answer those questions quickly, I just won't be able to. So just something to keep in mind, and I may have to adjust office hours to account for that. So just stay tuned. If there's any information that is going to be helpful this week, I will post in the announcement section, like if I have to change office hours or whatever the case may be, just things to keep in mind. I hope you all are doing well. We're really rocking and rolling now in week four. So stay tuned, and I will in the future post the videos and rubrics for our more major assignments that are coming down the line. But right now, it's just us still getting used to our week-to-week assignments. All right, hang in there. Good luck.